Yeah. So good afternoon and welcome to the another lecture of semester 1 Nagpur University RTM Nagpur University syllabus BSc first year. Now we were studying the subject electronics in paper 2 unit 2 and we have completed some of the gates in which we have in the last class we have studied about AND gate, NAND gate, OR gate, NOT gate, those three basic gates, and then universal gate, NAND and NOR gate. I guess you have understood that, and if you have any queries on that, you can put it on the WhatsApp group or you can put it on the comments on YouTube channel. Right. Today we are going to continue the same gates. So we have studied 5 gates and 2 more gates are there. Those are the 2 special gates. We call them as the special gates. So these gates are, so the special gates, 2 gates are there, special gates. I guess I expect that my board is visible and words are you are able to read those words. So we are having 2 special gates. The first gate is called as the XOR gate. XOR gate means exclusively OR gate. Exclusively OR gate. So it is like that is why it is called as XOR gate. So exclusively OR gate. And why it is called as exclusively OR gate? Because it is having some of the parameter of OR gate and then of say a difference between OR and XOR. So XOR gate. Now as we have written there in 5 points, the definition is same. So we'll be writing all the gates in the same patterns in these points, like definition, then a Boolean expression, then we'll have you be using the symbol, then truth table, and then working, right? So yeah, so the definition is the output whenever there is difference of inputs. I will explain you this. Whenever there are different inputs, remember these words. Whenever there are different inputs, then the output is high. Whenever there are different inputs, the output is high. Or for different inputs, the output is high. Otherwise, it is low. Now, what it actually means? Whenever we are having different inputs, means say we are expecting that the gate is having 2 inputs and 1 output, right? As we have studied up till now. So we are having 2 inputs and 1 output. Now the probability in which we are expected to give the inputs are zeros and ones only. So if I draw the truth table of that, so it will be like somewhat like this. So A and B, we are expecting them to be the inputs, and Y is supposed to be the output. The equation expression is Y XOR B. This is the symbol for XOR, plus and round, right? So the probabilities are 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. So these are the probabilities in which we are expected to give the inputs, right? So I guess he has not yet admitted. So these are the probabilities in which we are expecting to give the inputs. And what are the outputs? As the definition says, for different inputs, which means that when both the inputs are different, means one is 0 and the other one is 1, right? So in that case, only the output is supposed to be 1. Otherwise, it is 0. For same inputs, the output is 0 or low. For the same inputs, the output is low. So this is the basic definition of XOR gate. I'm repeating it for you. For different inputs, the output is high, and for same inputs, the output is low, right? So whenever there are different inputs to a gate, then the output is high. Otherwise, it is low, right? And the truth table is like this. Boolean expression, I will write that expression like this. So expression, Boolean expression is Y equal to A XOR B. like this, A XOR B. XOR is written as plus and a circle. As in a circle, we are having a plus sign over there. So that is the symbol for XOR. So A XOR B. And in detail, if you want to write that in equation form, so that can be written as A dot, A bar dot B plus A dot B bar. So this is the basic expression for the XOR gate. So Y is equal to A XOR B. This can also be written in simplified manner as we require it. So that can be written as A bar dot B plus A dot B bar, right? And if we talk in terms of the symbol of the XOR gate, so it's just similar to OR gate like this. Just a basic difference that we have to add one more line in front of it. So it will be, I guess it is not visible from that end. I will just draw it again. So this is like this. So XOR gate plus one more line in joining. So this will give you the symbol of XOR gate. So this is, these are two inputs and this is the output. Y equal to A XOR B. Right. So this is one of the special gate. I'm repeating it for you again. So we are studying, we have studied five gates, three basic gates, two universal gates, NAND and NOT, and the sixth gate is the special gates. First in that is XOR gate, which we call it as the exclusively OR gate. And the definition is whenever there are different of inputs, the output is high, or when different inputs are given to a gate and the output is high, then it is then that particular gate is called as the XOR gate. Otherwise, the output is low. For same input, the output is low, right? So that is called as the XOR gate. So XOR gate, exclusively OR gate is over there. Now, similarly, we have another gate which called as the second special gate. We call it as XNOR gate. So the basic difference of XOR and XNOR is, XNOR is a complement of XOR gate, right? XOR is complement of XOR gate. XNOR is complement of XOR gate, right? So students go on joining, right? So XNOR gate is just opposite of it. So the definition will change like, whenever there are different inputs, then the output is low. Otherwise it is high. For same input, the output is high. For different inputs, the output is low, right? So, So that is the definition of XNOR gate. So I'm just changing high to low and low to high. That's all. The definition remains the same. Now for the equation can be written as Y equal to A XOR B bar like this, or in another form, we can write like A dot B plus A bar dot B bar, right? So this is the equation for XNOR gate, and say for the symbol is same, just a difference is that we have to add one bubble in front of that. So it will be XOR gate. So this is A, this is B, and Y will be A XOR B complement like this. Right, so XOR gate, and XNOR gate. Truth table will be same, just the opposite of this. So I'm writing over here itself. In front of that, the probabilities are going to same. Just it is going to change 1001. So remember this. This is XNOR, the complement of XOR gate. So wherever there are zeros, it will convert it to one, and where there are one, it is converted to zero. Right, so these are the two gates that we have to complete. So in all we have learned seven gates. I'm just repeating it for you. The first gate was AND gate. If first and second input are high, then only the output is high, otherwise it is low. OR gate, if first or second or both the inputs are high, then only the output is high, otherwise it is low. That is OR gate. Third gate is NOT gate, that is the output is the complement of the input. And NAND gate, that is the first universal gate. So AND plus NOT will give you NAND gate, right? The definition if first and second input are high, then only the output is low, otherwise it is high. clear? Then NOR gate. If first or second or both the inputs are high, then only the output is low. Otherwise, it is high. These are five gates that we have studied. Three basic gates, two universal gates. And today we have completed two special gates. The first one is XOR gate, which is called as exclusively OR gate. The definition is when both the inputs of a gate is different, then only the output will be high. Otherwise, it is low. The definition is same. If we are different, different means both are different. So if one should be zero and the other one should be one, right? So 1 0 or 0 1, that might be the combination. But if they are having the same input, that is both are zero or both are one, the output will be low, right? So 0 1 1 0. So this is the truth table for say the XOR gate. Similarly for XNOR gate, this is the equation A XOR B, A bar dot B plus A dot B bar. So this is the equation of simplified equation of the XOR gate. I'm repeating it for you. Y equal to A bar dot B plus A dot B bar. And this is the symbol of XOR gate. It is same like OR gate, just a line in front of that. If you draw that line, then it will become a XOR gate. So I guess you are able to view this. This is a separate line I have drawn over there. So this is a separate line and this is a separate line. So that is called as XOR gate. And for XNOR gate, it is the complement of XOR gate. And that can be written, the definition can be written as whenever there are different inputs, the output is low. Otherwise, it is high. Right? Same. Just low and high, you have to change. The truth table is change like this. It is the complement of the XOR. So I'm changing that. The symbol is this. The equation is A XOR B complement or A dot B plus A bar dot B bar. That is the equation of XOR. I guess you have understood this. So we'll just complete this. And if you have any questions, I can say explain those answers for that, so that we can land on the other part of this, another topic, we can continue with that. So the another topic will be, I guess, we'll be going to see the De Morgan's theorem, right? So De Morgan's theorem, I am going to start with today now. XNOR, okay, Sanket. XNOR is same, it is just opposite or just complement of XOR gate, right? So XNOR ka definition kya hoga? Whenever there are different inputs, then the output is low, otherwise it is high. For the same inputs, the output is high. For different inputs, the output is low. That is called as XNOR gate, exclusively NOR gate. XOR ka complement, yani humne iske samne kya kiya hai? We have put a NOT gate in front of this gate, right? So you'll get this equation, A XOR B complement. Right? So we have just added one NOT gate in front of that XOR gate. So you'll be having the complement of that, right? So that is why it is called as XNOR gate, exclusively NOR gate. And the equation is Y equal to A XOR B complement. Simplified equation is A dot B plus A bar dot B bar. We have to simplify those. And this is the symbol. It is similar to XOR gate. Just we have to put one bubble in front of that XOR gate. So you'll be having the same, the symbol of that. So I guess you have understood. Do you have any problem in that again? Or else I need to repeat?
No, sir.
Chalo, okay, it's good. So I guess you have understood both the gates. So in all, we have completed 7 gates. And or not, 3 basic gates, universal gate, NAND and NOR, and 2 special gates, XOR and exclusively OR. I guess I have given you assignment. So we will be starting with a new topic, that is De Morgan's theorem. That is D-E Morgan's, M-O-R-G-A-N, apostrophe S, De Morgan's theorem. So basically, we are having two statements of De Morgan's theorem. I guess one of I will teach you one of the statements, and I expect from your side that you will be doing the other one. You just try it on. If you won't be able to do that, then I will be teaching you again. You don't worry about that. So the statement of De Morgan's theorem, the first De Morgan's theorem states that. So this is the first De Morgan's theorem. De Morgan's theorem. So you need to write it in words. I expect that my words are visible to you and they are readable also. So the first De Morgan's theorem states that complement of the sum A plus B complement. The complement of the sum is equal to the sum of the complements. Complement of the sum, is equal to product of the complements. The words are complement of a sum is equal to the product of the complements, right? So this is the first De Morgan's theorem. Complement of the sum A plus B complement is equal to A complement plus B complement. Sorry, A complement dot B complement. Complement of the sum is equal to product of the complement. This is the first statement of De Morgan's theorem, right? So now we have to prove that. So how you are going to prove that the first statement of the De Morgan's theorem? So for that, what I will do is I will first consider that how we are going to do that. So we are having two ways to do that. The first one is I will try this. Say if I take A equal to 0 and say B equal to 0. Right. So what will be the value of A complement will be 1 and B complement will be 1. Like, right. And now let's continue. So if I add here 0 plus 0 complement. So this one is 0 plus 0 will give you complement. And this is 1 dot 1 complement. So it will be 0 plus 0 will give you 0. Complement is 1. And the output is, 1 ka complement 0, 0 dot 0 is 0. So the output is 0. You can go on putting all the probable inputs over there, and then you can prove one by one. So this is equation number 1, equation number 2, equation number 3, equation number 4, likewise. Like, so this is one of the method where we can put all the variables in all form. So now the next one will be 0 and this will be 1. Then we'll see whether it comes out to be or not. Or say there is one more easiest method that we can do is just make a short table of all these variables. So we are having two variables. So I will do that for you. So I'm making a table of it and we'll try to solve that. So we are having two inputs like this. I guess it is visible to you all. Just let me know if it is not visible. I'm putting A over here. I will make a little bigger than that so that it is visible to you. So I'm making a table of all the probabilities like here. So I am putting over here A, I am putting over here B like this. Is that visible? Right. So yes, I am putting A complement over here in the next, and then I will be having B complement over here, and in the next I am taking it A plus B, and next I can get A plus B ka complement like this. And at the end, I can take A complement dot B complement. Is it visible? Right. So we are making in a tabular form. I'm making it in a table form and we'll put all the probabilities and we'll check whether these two columns match or not. When it matches, we'll conclude that A complement of the sum is equal to the product of the complements, right? Now let us check how we are going to do. So the probabilities in which A and B can be written are 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1, right? So these are only the four probabilities in which we are expecting to give the input to a gate, right? So 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. Now what would be A complement? A complement will be 1, 1, 1, 0, 0. What will be B complement? 1, 0, 1, 0. Right? So I'm just complementing this. So this is A, 0011 and the complement of A will be 1100. Is it okay? Have you got this? How I have done this? So I have taken A and B first. I have written all the probabilities 0001, 10, and 11. Right? Now we have to make the complement of A over here in this column. So I am making this A complement. So whatever there is 0, we have to transform it to 1. Right? So 00 can be written as 11. 11 can be written as 00. Right? Similarly, for B complement, B is 0101. So B complement will be 1010. Right? I guess you have understood. Now for addition. So we have to add A plus B. So A plus B means ANDing operation. So we have to add this. A plus B will, OR operation. So A plus B will give you 0111. Is it okay? Now the complement of that will be 1000. Complement of A plus B here. So we are writing the complement of A plus B. A plus B is written over here. 0111. And the complement of A plus B will be 1001. 1000, right? Now, in the last portion, we have to make A complement dot B complement, right? So, A complement dot B complement. So, this is A complement dot B complement. 1.1 will give you 1. 1.0 will give you 0. 0.1 will give you 0. And 0.0 will give you again 0. So, if you are able to see that these two columns are equal and having same outputs as shown over there. So A plus B, sum of complement of sum is equal to the product of the complements, right? So both are same, and hence we can conclude that a complement of sum can be written as complement product of complements. So this is the words that exact words that we have to say, that is the complement of a sum is equal to the product of the complements. Complement of the sum is equal to the product of the complements. Yeah, so I guess you have understood the De Morgan's first theorem statement is complement of the sum is equal to the product of the complements. And this is how we are going to prove. I have made a table of this A, B, A bar, B bar, A plus B, A plus B bar, A bar dot B bar, right? And I have shown how these two columns matches with each other. And hence we can conclude that A plus B bar is equal to A bar dot B bar, right? Now, just answer the question whether you are able to do the second De Morgan's theorem. Now, the second De Morgan's theorem statement is, this is the second De Morgan's theorem. That is again the almost the same. So, the second De Morgan's theorem states that complement of the product, so A dot B whole complement, complement of the product is equal to the sum of the complements. Yani A dot B bar is equal to A bar plus B bar, right? So this is the statement of De Morgan's second theorem. De Morgan's second theorem states that the complement of a product is equal to the sum of the complements. I guess you have understood these words, right? So remember this word. Whenever you need to write the statement, right? And then you have to write the expression. The first you have to write the statement. The statement is for the De Morgan's second theorem, complement of the product is equal to sum of the complements, which is shown over here. So are you able to prove this, or shall I continue, or shall I tell you how we have to complete this? The method will be same. You might go one by one, step one, step two, step three, putting all the probabilities like this, and equation one, equation two, equation three, equation four, and then you can say that as shown in equation four, one, two, three, four, this is true for all. That can be proved. or else you can go through this table and you can show that A dot B bar is equal to A bar plus B bar, right? So I will just show it to you, and I will expect from your side that you are doing it in an assignment, right? So let us do that. So I will change this all. So yes, I will change this also and this also. So what we require over here is now the table will remain same. Just we need to change what? We need to change this. So it is A dot B complement, and this is A dot B complement, right? So here we have, earlier we have taken A plus B and then A plus B complement. Now in this case we are taking A dot B and A dot B complement. Similarly, here we need to change that we want A complement plus B complement as shown in the right hand side. So left hand side is A dot B complement and the right hand side is A complement plus B complement. Now let us start with that. So A dot B means ANDing operation, right? Simple AND operation. So the AND operation will give you 0, 0, 0, 1. Right, and A dot B is 0, 0 will give you 0, 0, 1 will give you 0, 1, 0 will give you 0, and 1, 1 will give you 1. Complement of AND will be A dot B ka complement. So 0 jahan hai wahan 1, this is 1, this is 1, this is 1, and this is 0. So this is the output of A dot B whole complement. And what would be the answer of A complement plus B complement? So this is A complement and this is B complement. Right, so yes, so we need to continue with that. So A complement plus B complement, add this. So 1 plus 1 will give you 1, 1 plus 0 will give you 1, 0 plus 1 will give you 1, and 0 plus 0 will give you 0. This is OR operation. Again, you are able to see that both these columns are same, right? So hence we can conclude that the second statement of De Morgan's theorem can be proved as the complement of the product, is equal to sum of the complements. Complement of the product is equal to the sum of the products. I guess you have understood how these two statements can be proved. So De Morgan's first theorem, in which we need to prove that the complement of the sum is equal to the product of complements, right? This is the first statement. And in the second statement, we are having the complement of the product is equal to the sum of the complements, right? So remember the statements and just try to write this as an assignment. After the completion of these 7 gates, we are using this De Morgan's theorem. So this is the another statement that we expect that we'll be doing this in practical also. So we need to prove that. So A dot B bar is equal to A complement dot A complement plus B complement, right? So I guess you have understood. If you have any questions, you can say ask, or you can put it on the chat box, or you can unmute yourself and ask the question. Do you have any questions on that? Anybody, have you understood this? Or else you can say, yeah, yes, sir, we have got it. Yes, Rinki. Anybody can unmute and ask a question? Okay, Sanket, you have understood. Thank you, Buddha. Or koi hai, jisko samjha hai ya nahi samjha hai. So that I will come to know whether you have understood or not. Okay, so I expect that you have understood. Thank you, Rinki, Manish. Thank you very much. So I guess you have understood. So we'll end the class over here and we'll continue in the next class tomorrow at 11:30. So be there, be regular, and if you have any problems, let me know. Yeah, go through my YouTube channel. I will be uploading this video also on YouTube. So please stay on that. And I guess, just hold. Thank you very much for joining. And I guess you have understood the 7 gates, 7 digital gates, and then the De Morgan's theorem, 2 statements of the De Morgan's theorem. And I expect from your side that you will be writing it on your own. Write on your. Thank you very much for joining, and go through my YouTube channel, watch my videos, try to like it also and share it. my videos. Thank you very much. Have a nice time. Stay home, stay safe, take care. See you soon. Bye.